Our meeting is based on that of Allah Almighty, that of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that of Awliyaullah, and Ahlul Bayt al-Nabi and Sahabati Rasulullah and all Awliyaullah azza wa jalla. Basing ourselves on this stable base, then we build our building. Our building is the building of Islam. The building of Islam, as any building you get from the construct to make a building, but then this building you cannot put in it except to finish it. Even to finish it by the luxury, or you finish it by anything, so cheap things. To finish it by so cheap things means that no benefit, no good price you can get to buy and sell, because no one would accept to have anything which is cheap. Everyone sells it for something which is expensive. And so if you finish by luxury, then it will bring for you good price. And by this, the building which is based on love of Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and love of Awliya and Ahlul Bayt, if it is built, and then it is finished by realities and spiritualities, then everyone will be happy to come and to buy and sell with it. But if you finish it by common things, by knowledge which is related to common ones, to common people, then no one will be willing to be coming to ask to buy any apartment from this building. And Allah Almighty is saying, for all whom they are far away from reality, they are in the illat al-an'am walhum adallu sabila. They are like an'am. What is the meaning of an'am? Domestic animal, like chicken, like goat, sheep. These domestic animals, Allah says an'am, from ni'ma, from good cousins. And so they are like these animals, the common ones. So people, they are like animals, even worse. Because whatever they are making, or practicing, or worshipping, it is all coming in through their ego, and their proudness, and their feeling themselves they are doing something important to Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty, He says, أنا الغني والحميد. I am the rich and the great one, that I don't need for all whatever you worship, because I am Allah Almighty, praising myself by myself, and not going to increase by your praising or decrease by your non-praising me. I am Allah Almighty. Praising, the benefit of it coming to you. Worshipping, the benefit of it coming to you. And so if you do all these worshipping by proudness and seeing that you are doing something to Allah Almighty, then Allah will not accept. You will be with them like the animals whom they know nothing except that they are living to eat and drink and to pray and worship Allah Almighty, but they are animals. Even worse, Allah Almighty says, because you are human beings, you are Khalifa of me, and you are doing like these animals. Allah Almighty loves the one who tries their best to worship Allah Almighty by spirituality, by reality. To worship Allah Almighty, not by yourself, But to worship Allah Almighty by Allah Almighty to Allah Almighty. To worship Allah Almighty by Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to Allah Almighty. As Rasulullah makes all the Sahaba to worship Allah Almighty and to practice Islam, not by themselves, but by Rasulullah to Allah Almighty. By Allah Almighty to Allah Almighty, until Rasulullah is dead, my Sahaba, my companions, they are like stars. By anyone, you guide yourself, you will be well guided. Sahaba can resume, the ajram of Sadaytum, is Sadaytum. My companion like stars, by anyone who guides yourself, you follow, you will be well guided to reach to Allah Almighty and Rasulullah. And every Sahaba passing away, he was giving his secret to one of the followers whom they followed the Sahaba. And for this, the followers, Tabi'een, they are very important in Islam like Sahaba. Because all of them are blessed by the secret of the Sahaba. Because Allah Almighty given Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 124,000 Sahaba. 124,000 companions. According to 124,000 prophets of Allah Almighty. Every Sahaba, Rasulullah was blessing him by a secret of one of the prophets. Every Sahaba represents one prophet. And the secret of 124,000 prophets, Maulana says, Allah did this secret of prophecy and he kept it on earth. He didn't take it up to heaven. And he ordered them and everyone to inherit his secret to one of the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Since no more prophets after seed of prophets, the Sahaba, they were giving the secret to the followers or to their successors, Awliyaullah, to Awliya. And so this in every period of time, there is 124,000 Awliya according to the number of Sahaba, according to the number of the prophets, because every Awliya represents the secret of prophecy of one prophet. And between this 124,000 Awliya, there is five Qutub, who represent the five Ulil Azm, the five powerful prophets, which means Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, Sayyidina Ibrahim, Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Isa, and King of Prophet Bilal, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the one between these Qutub who represent Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be known as the Ghawth, Sultan of Awliya. Because he is representing the divine secret of prophecy of fear of prophets, with all the secrets of prophets coming from him to all the prophets. From him going on to all the 124,000 prophets. And from him to all 124,000 Sahaba. And to him, from him to all 124,000 Awliya. And in every period of time, just as an Awliya passed away, quickly another one will be taking his place and blessed by these people. Why Allah Almighty giving Awliya? Why Allah Almighty keeping Awliya? Allah Almighty keeping Awliya because no one of the nation of Rasulullah or children of Adam alayhi salam can reach to this reality of the divine presence of Allah Almighty unless he is guided by one of these Awliya. Without the guidance of this Awliya, no one can reach. Even you memorize the whole Quran, even you do by all the Sharia, and you memorize all books and hadith, never you can reach to Allah Almighty. You will be still blind. You need a Holy Quran. What kind of the Holy Quran you need? You need a talking Holy Quran. This Holy Quran in between our hands is a silent one. You are reciting. There is a talking Holy Quran. And the talking Holy Quran is Awliyaullah. Sultan of Awliya represents the talking Holy Quran. Because he will give you and the Awliya will guide you through these ayat to reach to Allah Almighty. Why did we are memorizing or reading the Holy Quran? Only with just good tidings and the blessing from Allah Almighty, but never you will reach to Allah Almighty. Never you reach to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Only you need a one to guide you and to take by your hand in this way, in this road leading to Allah Almighty. For example, if you want to reach to the sun, how will you reach to the sun? If you want to reach to the sun, you must walk on the rays of the sun. Anyone walking on the rays of the sun, at the end is going to reach to the sun. So you need a piece from light, so that can carry you and to walk on the rays over the rays until you reach the sun. And the same, you need a one who will dress you by a body, a light body, that can make you to enter into the ayat of the Holy Quran until you reach to the divine presence of Allah Almighty. And this one is known as the talking for the Quran, not the silent one. And so this you must tell for an audience to follow him. Allah Almighty tells for an audience and follow him. And if you follow him, follow him tight to the Jannah which Allah mentioned in the Holy Quran. If Allah mentions about Jahannam, you will step in Jahannam as Rasulullah in the night Mi'raj. In the Mi'raj he said, and see what goes on in Jahannam. Like this, awliyaullah, they enter into the Holy Quran and take divine knowledge. When they read, for example, Qul huwa Allahu Ahad, they reach to know about uniqueness, the ocean of uniqueness. When they reach to Allah, they know and enter to know and to be led by the knowledge of the oneness of Allah Almighty, wa ahdaniya of Allah Almighty. When they reach to say, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, they enter into the ocean of لا إله إلا الله and see whatever light Allah Almighty is appearing from it and how it is reflecting in Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Like this, awliya recite the Holy Quran. This is features of the Holy Quran. And whatever awliya they have knowledge, nothing compares to the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the knowledge of Rasulullah cannot be compared with the knowledge of Allah Almighty. And even though Allah Almighty giving Rasulullah and the resulting in the reality of Rasulullah, all the oceans of the Holy Quran, all the ocean of knowledge, wisdom, secret, divine begotten knowledge, all endorsed in the reality of Rasulullah, even though Rasulullah he said, oh Allah Almighty, give me ilma. Give me more and more knowledge, because you know your knowledge is much more higher than all this yet. Give me from your divine knowledge, O Allah Almighty. And this divine begotten knowledge is Allah Almighty will give to Rasulullah when he is ascending in this two worlds or less, from pre-eternal to eternal forever. And every time Allah opening for him new oceans, new heavens, new kingdom of Allah Almighty, that all whatever he read and known from Allah Almighty will disappear, will be swallowed by this new opening which Allah offered to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every less than blink of an eye. From one blink of an eye to another, it will be open, where all the past ones will be totally swallowed, and new heavens and kingdoms and divine the ocean of open for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this, the awliya of nowadays, according to where Rasulullah now is reaching, closer to Allah Almighty and his knowledge, which now is open before was not open to Rasulullah, is blessing them from this new ocean of knowledge and wisdom and secret. And for this, one of the awliya of nowadays, or the Sultan of awliya of nowadays, cannot be compared with the ones whom they came before him. Much more higher, much more higher. And the one who come after will be much more higher than now, until Yawm al-Qiyamah like this. And Allah Almighty, I am keeping awliya. I am keeping these awliya to be in between the nations to Yawm al-Qiyamah. Because without this awliya, no one can reach to my divine presence or can be under my رضوان الله الأكبر. What is رضوان الله الأكبر؟
The great pleasure of Allah.
The great pleasure of Allah Almighty. In fact, they will be all under the great anger of Allah Almighty and punishment. And for this, Allah Almighty saying in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. O Mu'mins, be blessed by piety and be with a truthful one, with a truthful one. Follow him. And then Allah is describing, giving description, who is the truth one? How you can know that this is the truth one or not? How to follow a one, and if you don't know his description from Allah Almighty. What Allah Almighty saying about this truth one? رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُ اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبًا وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى لِغَمَا بَجَّلِ تَبْدِيرًا. They are men, because they reach to the position to be men, not to be animals or common ones or babies, not yet, they are yet cutting wings from their mother, but they are men, mature men. In the divine presence of Allah Almighty, Allah Almighty is saying, رجالهم, they are the ones whom they were sadaku. They were sincere of صدق الله الجميل وصدقهم مع الله whom they were fulfilling what they promised in the day of covenant and promises in Allah Almighty and fulfilling it. Never one a blink of an eye they are out of fulfilling what they promised in the day of promises and covenants with Allah Almighty. صدقوا مع عهد الله عن fulfilling all whatever they promised Allah Almighty and making as a covenant with Allah Almighty. فمنهم من قضى نحبه. Some of them they passed away. This is the thing, another one who is alive. فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر and there is still whom they are alive. يوم القيامة لا يجب between the Ummah to make the Ummah to reach to reality and to the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. And one day Rasulullah was announcing in the divine holy of Rasulullah, divine hall of Rasulullah, whom of you awliya will sacrifice himself on behalf of my nation so that they can reach to the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. And what I would say, they were there, who dare to give sacrifice themselves such a sacrificing, they cannot carry or tolerate it. That man said, because the Ya Rasulallah, I will sacrifice myself. And he chose to be from all awliya, that he was the one to sacrifice himself on behalf of the nation. What does he mean sacrificing himself? On behalf of the nation, so that all the nation of Rasulullah will get the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. Meaning that all whatever he gained and learned from Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, from just the one thing that he passed away, whatever he learned from high maqam, he will give it to the nation of Rasulullah so that Allah will look at them as if he is looking at him. And he will take from all of them all their badness, linkage of crime, making bad deeds, sins, all of which Allah Almighty doesn't like, he will carry it on himself and he will give them all whatever Allah will give him from my maqam. He told him, I will create Ya Rasulullah. And we say, I am Yawm al-Qiyamah going to stand in front of Allah Almighty as if the most sinner one. The one who is the one representing drinking wine, adultery, making all badness, all sins, like this I will be, and whatever Allah blesses me, it will be blessed to all the nation of Rasulullah. And this is the secret between me and Rasulullah. No one of the awliya can interfere what is between me and Rasulullah. And he passed away by him. He entered into seclusion. Before he passed away, he entered into seclusion for 3 months, not eating. Only the 24 hours he would drink a little bit of very icy water, cold ice water, on I was telling him. Then he passed away later. He said, I am telling all the nation of Rasulullah and the fighting themselves. Otherwise, the man never reaching to be a mature in reality and the spirituality, he will be like a very sucking milk from his mother. One a senior deputy and caliph of one of our grand sheikh in the Naqshbandi line. This grand sheikh was the imam of the Qasim al-Qadha Khan, Sayyidina Abdul Khaliq al-Wazawan. He had a serial deputy that always is showing himself between all the Mu'ids and all the deputies, caliph of the sheikh, that he is the most important. I am going to be the successor. I am going to be the most important one. Always sheikh addressing me. He loves me. He is making me to represent him everywhere. You are nothing. The sheikh knows what's going on the top. He told him, my son, I was going to visit all my police when they passed away in the graveyard. But I am old now. I am choosing you between all movies and deputies to go and visit on my behalf. Go to the cemetery graveyard and visit all the senior movies of whom they passed away. And so I want to say, this he was also much more proud now telling all the movies and deputies and the group there. Choosing me for this, not all of you. And he wants, and the sheikh looking at him from the Zawiya of him, from his Zawiya looking at him. Zawiya arrived to the graveyard. He was seeing that the, at that time they used to make a fence and a door for the graveyard so no wild animal or anything will enter and bump. Always very close. They said there is a funeral, they go, of course, it's not funeral, it is closed. And he reached and he saw that the door is closed and there is a big lock. Lock. He tried to open it and was not able to reach to the one who has the key. He said, how is my sheikh sending me? He doesn't know that how I am saying he is a big sheikh and he is our sheikh and know everything. He doesn't know that the gate is locked. And I cannot ask her sending me to visit. That's all of a sudden, a very old man coming, passing. Also, he comes to the door, to the graveyard. He told, what are you doing here, my son? He told them, I am coming to visit the senior police of my sheikh. But I am seeing that the door is locked. They also want to ask her and to visit the graveyard. The whom they are buried in this cemetery. And so said, you cannot because it is locked. When this old man looked at the lock like this by his eyes and the lock hit and the door locked. He said, this Maurice from one of the crazy man is coming to me now. He told me, and I want to visit my whom I want to visit and visit whom you want to visit. Then this old sheikh would be going to be buried. Senior Murid, who was the sheikh of Islam of the country, he was taking bay'ah from Sayyidina Abu Khalid al-Zawani, and he was more than 95 years old, he passed away and died. And so he was this old man standing on his grave. For some reason, this Murid, he said in his mind, I will start with the sheikh of Islam because he's senior Murid. 95 years old, and he was very tired, and he was so close to Sayyidina Abu Khalid al-Husawani, I would visit him and give him salam from Sayyidina Abu Khalid al-Husawani. So he went there, Maulana said, well, I'm telling you, he saw that this old man standing before him, بدأت يريد الفاتحة which if they open it for us, then we will be flying. No more the sun can tolerate us. And for this, Maulana and all Grand Sheikhs train their police like a fusion to make them police to maturity, so that we can then be threatened by realities and spiritualities, and so they can enter into the divine, the godly world of name. Because the one who is not able to enter into the divine, the godly world of peace, he will not be able to enter into the divine, the godly world of name. And the one who is not entering into the divine, the godly world of name, he cannot get his code number, the greatest name by which he is existing, to open the divine, the godly world of attributes. And the one who is not reaching the divine, the godly world of attributes, never he can reach to the divine world of oneness, of wahda, and of Allah Almighty. And the one who is never reaching to wahda, to oneness of Allah Almighty, how is he going to reach to the uniqueness of Allah Almighty? Never. And for this, now we are in the deep. If we are not able to be entering into every tiny, smallest, atom which cannot be split anymore. The atom is split until you reach that the atom cannot be split. If you are not entering into that in every unsplit of an atom, and let all these atoms by which all these universes and the creation are existing, you cannot be a knower of Allah Almighty. Knower of Allah Almighty, who is blessed by all kinds, all knowledge, all wisdom of every tiny unsplitted of an atom, which all these universes and all these creations, they are created from it. And so this atom is to split it, it will be split it to what you say, split it to what the atom is split it. Split to molecular, then you split them, it will be electron, I don't know what they call it. Electron, neutron, and proton, and electron, then you split to split until there is no more to split. It will be turned this atom to what? To energy. Energy means light of Allah Almighty. Everything from Allah of light, from the light of Allah Almighty. If you would not learn by this light of Allah Almighty, from which everything is appearing, never you be a knower of Allah Almighty. And if you are not a knower of Allah Almighty, how you are going to reach to divine the names and attributes, or divine the wellness or uniqueness, or to be under the reflection of the light or the essence of Allah Almighty? And so this one, Sultan of Saudiya, Awliya Allah, they say, La ilaha illallah. They will complete, they will enter into every time he tells. It cannot be split by saying La ilaha illallah until they will be dressed for saying illallah by all the light from which everything is created. This is to come to cover all the light of Allah Almighty, which Allah Almighty making all creation to be appeared in front of it. If you can cover it, then you will make zikr by Sultan of Zikr. This is Sultan of Zikr Mawlana, say Grand Sheikh and Mawlana. And Grand Sheikh, he said, and this is addressed also to Mawlana Sheikh Mawlana, Sultan of Awliya, that in every leaf, when I make what we call the breath is coming and coming, inhaling and exhaling. When he is inhaling, coming by Sultan of Zikr. When exhaling, coming, completing the secret of the Holy Quran. And the secret of the Holy Quran is anyone, one Awliya called Shihab-e-Din, who is the Imam of Mountain of God. When his father, Sayyidina Muhammad al-Badali, the grand Shaykh also, he passed away he was making his best day and night to make a khatam, to complete all the secrets of the Holy Quran, how we recite the Holy Quran and make a khatam from the first to the end. He was trying to make a khatam from the first to end of the secrets of Holy Quran. Day and night, by the power of wilayah, which is given to him from Allah Almighty and Rasulullah, and he took with him 3 months, day and night, to finish it. For example, Holy Quran, for awliya, 5, 8, 10 hours, by 10 hours they can complete. It took them 3 months to finish to make a complete khatam for the secret of the Holy Quran, and just to finish it, he gave it to his father as a gift, and then his father in his day told him, I will not take it, and then you will get a promise from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that all the claims of the Murid of Sayyidina Shaykh Shalaluddin Qasas Allah Tullu and the Lord Shaykh Mawlana Shaykh Abdullah Tawassani and Mawlana Shaykh Nazim, all the successors, all the Murid, their grace will be lighted by this light of the Holy Secret of Quran and the Islam. Then Rasulullah would not think that I give it to them. And for this Mawlana say, all my Murid, they will be just entering the grace blessed by the light of the Holy Secret of the Holy Quran by the service of Sayyidina Shaykh Abu Dhabi. And this took him 3 months. While Grand Sheikh is dead, with every daily, I am completing the whole secret of the Holy Quran, complete Khatam. And by every inhaling, he is completing the Sultan of Bidr, discovering all divine the attributes, divine the names, divine the deeds of Allah Almighty and all life, from which everything is created in the ocean of La ilaha illallah, appearing from La ilaha illallah. How many times he is exhaling and inhaling. And then this Mawlana Shaykh Nazim now, that inhaling, exhaling, like this, everyone going by the Ibad of the Holy Quran, the other coming by the Sultan of Zikr. Like this, they are serving the Murid and the nation of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this no one knows about them except the one whom they will reveal to him about themselves. They don't reveal to everyone these things. Because they know that no one can accept or believe. And but this what was witnessing from the Shaykh of Red Shaykh, that my son is like this, my son Abdullah Abdul is like this, and the Grand Sheikh says, whatever on me I bless it to my son Nazir Abdul Qawwam Ashakir. And so this we know that they have this. Otherwise, if Sayyidina Shaykh Shalabuddin was not to say no. And by this, the one who wants to reach these divine stations, he needs to have one guiding him, the one who has wings to make bless him by his wings to fly in this divine divine world of Allah Almighty. Otherwise no one with this physical body, with this humanity, with this ego, with our shaitan and our desires, you cannot even fly here half a meter. You can't fly, you need a one to make you to fly, to carry you. And if there is no one to carry you, there is no possibility to reach these stations, heavenly stations. And for this Allah Almighty blessing these heavenly stations for the ones whom is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Almighty, what is saying in the Holy Quran? وَقَضَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ أَشُدَّاءُ عَلَى الْكُفَّارِ وَحَضَاءُ بَيْنَهُمْ تَرَاهُمْ رُكَّعًا سُجَّدًا يَبْتَغُونَ فَضْلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرِضْوَانًا سِيمَاهُمْ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ مِنْ أَثَرِ السُّجُودِ. What is the meaning of this? Allah Almighty says, I am witness saying that you are my beloved Muhammad, you are my only Imam in my divine presence, and you are the one whom you are the prophet, you are the prophet and messenger of me, whom only I am witness is that you only alone, and all other prophets, they are from you taking, but you are the one whom they are taking from me direct. And the one with you, the one whom they are with you, وَالَّذِينَ مَعْ Allah Almighty says, also the one whom they are with Rasulullah, which means the one whom they are the inheriting successors of Rasulullah. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Imam Shaykh Najaf, وَالَّذِينَ مَعْ the one whom is in, Allah Almighty says in this ayah, in Surah Al-Qadr, in the Quran, أَشُدَّاوا عَلَى الْمُقْرَارِ they are very powerful and tough on the kafir, on their non-believers, not in the non-believers of kafir people, but on their physical power, which relates to their ego and satanic world, because always our ego and satanic world in our humanity is always kafir refusing Allah Almighty and disobeying Allah Almighty. They are very sharp, making them to be under their control quality. They are so merciful with their spiritual power, which is appearing in their realities and spiritualities of their soul. They are so merciful with it, so that anyone sitting with them can easily love them and be attracted to them and to come to them. Why all this? Allah Almighty says, يَبْتَغُونَ فَضْلًا مِنَ اللَّهِ They are asking only Allah to be pleased. And they are asking for the great pleasure from Allah Almighty. Nothing else. They don't want Jannah. They don't want paradise. They don't want anything. Only they want the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. And to Allah be pleased from them. You will see them always in ruku' or in sujood. All their life is praying to Allah Almighty, either in the ruku' or going to sujood with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so they were the VIP whom Allah told them to be ascending with Rasulullah. And his 12,000, there is 12,000 mi'raj for Rasulullah, 12,000 ascending to Allah Almighty Rasulullah. He completed his 23 years of prophecy. And he only mentioned one of them. And the other he kept concealed and revealed only to these who they used to be with him ascending to Allah Almighty as a hashiya, what we call hashiya. Hashiya to Sultan, yani the one whom they are the around the king or the Sultan, the people around him. Yeah, the one whom they are the sisters, always the Sultan, and whom they are so close to Sultan. Like this, the Rasulullah has the successor to be always with him. He was every ascending taking him with him to ascend to the divine presence of Allah Almighty. And they are always in that ascending in ruku and sujood in between the hands of Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty mahalahum, shock them, you say, سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود. Time, not time, more than time that Allah Almighty stamped them on their forehead by a special light of the sujood up in between the hands of Allah Almighty. Not like nowadays people making here to be done so that this is the kind of sujood, not this one. But the love which Allah stamped on these whom they were with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah Almighty said in the Holy Quran, they are stamped by a special light from Allah Almighty from their sujood in between the hands of Allah Almighty up
in the divine decision of Allah Almighty.
And these are the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dividing his ummah on them to carry everyone carrying a part of the ummah of the nation of Rasulullah carrying it so that they are going to make all the ummah to be saved, all the nation to be saved and to be under the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. Without these people, from the light of the youth on their forehead, never anyone can reach to the great pleasure of Allah Almighty. And Allah Almighty, He says, then we continue the ayah that their example in the Bible and the Quran, Allah gives their description for the past nations for these whom they are Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And for this is awliyaullah, these the sultans of awliya. Not ordinary awliya, but they are the sultans of awliya. For they are blessed by sultanate from Allah Almighty and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be sultans of children of Adam alayhi salam. When they are representing the descending of the reflection of the absolute identity of Allah Almighty to His essence and from His essence descending the reflection to His uniqueness and then descending of His uniqueness to His oneness, wahdaniyya. They represent these divine lovely words of Allah Almighty. And these awliya, no one can reach them because they are hidden ones. Only Mawlana Kaknazim is appearing, either they are all hidden. And in every period of time, Allah will send only one. And for this, they are around 40 from time of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq till Mawlana Kaknazim, not more than 41. These awliya, between all awliya. And alhamdulillah, Allah Almighty, at last, and at least making us to be with one of them, and I follow two of them. Like Shaykh and Mawlana Kaknazim. But for you, at least one, you are with one of them, and for this, the one who they are with him, they will be reaching that maqam at the end. Never he will accept to bless any maqam, it is not left to all his glory. To make all of them to reach to that maqam. Like Rasulullah never accepting anything for himself from Allah Almighty except saying, my nation, my nation. Rasulullah just the God making sujood to Allah Almighty, coming to earth, making sujood, and saying, my ummah is my nation, my nation. When he gets prophecy, my nation, my nation. When he passed away, my nation, my nation. Yawm al Qiyamah, just he will be invited by Allah Almighty, defers to us, Allah, my nation, my nation. Like this, Rasulullah, Allah. And this audio like this, always taking care for their monies and the one whom they are following them. And the one who will follow, how to follow them? How to obey them? The following them and obeying them is how much you will be strict in their the order which is given to us. How much you are fulfilling what they give us to practice, how much you are connected with them. How much, for example, you give salat wa salam to Rasulullah, how much you are connected with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How much you make zikr, how much you are connected with Allah Almighty. How much you do your best to fulfill whatever Mawlana is giving you to practice, how much you will be in connection with him. How much you will God care for all this, you will be then not unconnected, but you will be then not mature. You will not reach the maturity, you will go from this life as a baby, sucking milk here, only smelling the taste, smelling the smell of Naqshbandi way, not reaching to the root to Naqshbandi. And for this, the one who connects himself and following, he will be reaching to the highest maqam. And to be in familiarity with them, Mawlana يا ودود لأن في إنسان فاميليارتي من أول جن ملائكة أولياء ريليشن because the sagacity of the name of Yawadud make a connection between you and between all the creation of Allah Almighty and Awliya and jinn and malaika. And Allah will lighten your heart by the name Yawadud and the name Yawadud make malaika to visit you, make jinn to visit you also, and make all the creation to come and take barakah from you. By the name of Yawadud. And everyone will continue every day 300 times Yawadud. After 40 days, you will start to see visions and openings and see things which was not able to see it before. By the name of Yawadud. And Allah will erase from him washat al-yukur, the washat. وحشة النفس يعني الله will erase from him the وحشة means the badness of the ego which cover the heart to be always upset and not happy. If Yawadud on this for 300 times it would erase it and make the heart always happy and feeling in familiarity with Allah Almighty with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and with all creation and awliya Allah. May Allah forgive us and mercy us now to the Isha'a and the Isha'a and the Isha'a.
Allah makes them to be involved and enter into the Fatiha.
أن تولد رسول الله يوسف زي في فاتحة أن تولد كبير سؤال إطلاقش أو أي نيشن إستاذ قومي عن أي نيشن أن دي فاتحة It's all contained, the whole Quran and it's not open. It is engulfed in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is the greatest name. Inside Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the greatest name of Allah Almighty. What is the greatest name of Allah Almighty? What is the greatest name? Bismillah. 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 What is? You know what is? No one knows. Because Allah Almighty, what is the saying of the other Quran? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. It is the greatest name of Allah Almighty. And for the one who say every day, 100 times, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, until it is written in his book 70,000, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, Allah will build for him a palace in his neighborhood, Mawlana Sayyid and Grand Sheikh, and then he will open for him to reach the greatest name. If he completes a 70,000 Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in his life. And so this, Allah saying, what is the meaning? How to translate Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? It's in English. Translate it. Shaykh Ajwa al-Arab. You are in faith. Alim. How? What? No. But on the first, Bismillah.
Bismillah. By the name of Allah.
By the name of Allah. What is the name? By the name of Allah. What is this name? That Allah says, by the name of Allah Almighty. There is a name of Allah Almighty. By this name of Allah Almighty, who is the most plentiful, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim? What is this name? Allah kept it vivid, vivid function. Because cannot enter into letters. Because Allah is the creator. And his name cannot carry be carried in letters. And so for this Allah Almighty only signing and referring by the name which no one knows except me, the greatest name of my essence, who you know me only by the name Allah, by the name, this hidden name of Allah Almighty. Bismillah, by the name of Allah. What name of Allah? By the name of Allah is Al-Rahman Al-Rahim. And in it, it is written the greatest name, and for this, all the whole Quran and the Fatiha entering into Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And all the knowledge of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and all these oceans of the wisdom and secret divine knowledge of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, they are in the Nukta, in the pond, under the badger of the pond, they are in the pond. Which means nothing. Point means nothing. All these knowledge, nothing. If there is no name, if there is no one, then this point is zero. This point, like zero, because zero would be nothing. You need beside it to put one. If there is one, then this zero will activate. And all this knowledge, without the one who is Allah Almighty, all this knowledge is not. And for this, all awliya getting their knowledge from the point of the being through the one who is Allah Almighty. How much you put zeros on the left side of the one is very important? No important. If you put them on the right hand, then it will be number 10, 100,000, 100,000, 1 million, 100 million, billion. How much you put zeros? And for this, how much there is nothing, no existence, for whatever appears, no existence, all existing by the one, by Allah Almighty, then they are something. Otherwise, they will be zero, nothing on the left side of the one. And for this to be two, it means one. To be three, it means one. To be four, it means one. To be five, it means one. The four, it means one to be five. The six, it means one to be six. Otherwise, it will remain five. And all numbers Which means all creations, they need the one. Who is the one? Allah Almighty. And so this is his name, one of his names, Al-Wahid Al-Ahad. Al-Wahid. One of the name of Allah Almighty, he's the one. And this is the oneness of the Aliyah of Allah Almighty. Al-Ahad is the uniqueness of Allah Almighty, Ahad also the one. And so this always be with the one and never be worried from anything. But if you are not with the one, then you are going to be scared by even an ant. An ant, it means one. While Allah Almighty is blessing an ant, it will be like awliya, powerful. Even if it is an ant. Now, if Allah is blessing from His godly power to an ant, Sayyidina Sulaiman, now we are in a new story coming. Sayyidina Sulaiman, Prophet Sulaiman, alayhi salam, he had an army cannot be imagined. From his right hand, mankind. From his left hand, jinn. Over him, birds. All there were his army. Not thousands or hundred thousands, jinn, billions. Mankind, they were 100,000. And first, they covered the sky over the Imam, Prophet Sulaiman and his army. And when they are well dressed by all their armors or weapons, and they go after Sayyidina Sulaiman in the war, to call people in another country to come to Islam, to be believers. And he was going, Allah is Allah Almighty saying in the Holy Quran, قالت لم لكم قالت لم لكم أن قالت أن سأل يا أيها النمل كلوا مذابلكم and the voice because the feet of the army of Sayyidina Sulaiman they were shaking the earth when they are walking it's all shaken and this ant ants. He said, in the valley of ants, where there are billions of ants, one ant. Allah blessing with godly power, he said, how anyone can hear the voice of an ant? Billions of an ant can hear the voice of an ant with this army shaking the earth and making so much noise. That Allah saying, قَالَتْ لَمْ لَكُمْ One ant. He said, billions of ants, all ants, enter quickly into your houses. Under the earth, because now the army of Sulaiman is going to destroy all of you. And all the ants in this valley, perhaps more than 20, 30, 40 kilometers, all hearing her voice, and all of them, they were covering themselves under the earth in their houses. And Allah Almighty making all the prophets to Sulaiman to hear the voice of this earth, and to laugh, and to say, فَتَوَسَّلُوا صَاحِفًا مِنْ قَوْلِيَ فَتَوَسَّلُوا قَالَ رَبِّ أَوْزَعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نَعْمَتَكَ أَنْ تَلِمُوا Allah Almighty make me to thank you that you are making me to hear this earth from this long distance. 30 kilometers in the valley of the earth, so that he make all the army not to cross this valley, but to turn there to another mountain, to another road to take, and not to destroy the earth. He was an ant, Allah put a power in it, an ant, giving a voice of 30,000 kilometers, 30 kilometers, full with ants. And all of them, they are hearing their voice by thunder. And they are covering themselves into their houses. And when Allah Almighty wants to put His secret even in the weakest one, He will be the most powerful one. Allah Almighty. Because the orientation of Maulana and his ocean of knowledge always opening. When he opens the station, difficult to close it. And then he will close it. Sometimes he gives it, or even there is no one, I wait for him to come, as if he is making Qabla for me. I will hear all this knowledge coming. So before another story will come, because one day this knowledge, divine knowledge will come, teaching how the power of Allah Almighty even in an earth it will be God's power, that it will be much more powerful than Prophet who was able to hear her voice. Otherwise, difficult time of the Rana to hear the voice of an ant. Anyone can hear the voice of an ant? Now there is hundreds or thousands of ants walking. You can hear their voice? How can the Rana from 30 kilometers hearing the voice of this ant and all the ants hearing their voice? What kind of an ant? And Allah saying, an ant, like this, an ant, was saying. And not giving so important. One ant, say. But that's even weak, that's why God the power from Allah Almighty. How about children of Adam alayhi salam, if he's blessed by God the power, what he can do? Think about it. And when you find the answer, tell me. على رسولنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه.